Curves look great, don't they? But trying to sketch designs on them can be a real challenge. Fortunately, SolidWorks provides several features to help make this process easier. Our previous video showed you how to take advantage of the Spline and wrap features to score and emboss a curved surface. This time round, we'll introduce you to three more ways to sketch onto curved geometry. We're going to create this crystal globe using curves and splines. This is a more advanced tutorial, but feel free to follow along and test your SolidWorks skills and patience. Do use the chapters in the time bar and description to jump to the different tools if you just want to see how they're used. We'll start things off in a new part, sketching a midpoint construction line and a circle on the front plane. Trimming one side before using the revolve feature about that central axis line to create a basic sphere. To make life a little more simple later on, we'll enable the direct editing tab in the command manager and use the Move Copy Body tool to make a copy of the sphere. We'll name these bodies and hide out the reference sphere for later. To make our globe, we need to trace the outline of the continent. Drag on a black and white picture of the world map from your Windows Explorer. With the advanced mapping options, we can orient it and control the size. Fitting the picture to the height and width of the body works well here. Now we can introduce the first of our new tools, Spline on Surface. Found buried deep under the Spline dropdown in the Sketch tab, this tool allows us to sketch a spline directly onto any face, whether they are curved or planar. It does this by creating a 3D sketch and adding an on-face relation to the spline. We need a reference sketch here, so we'll start tracing around our continents with the Spline on Surface command. This is going to take a bit of time to do, so we'll speed this bit up and recap a few useful tips for using splines in the meantime. It's best to keep splines as simple as possible. Splines are complex pieces of geometry, and the calculations involved in creating them can be very intensive on your computer's CPU. With larger curves, you can use fewer points, and you only really need to click at points where the curves change direction. We want to avoid overlapping lines. Clicking the endpoint of a spline will connect the previous spline and the new spline. Break up long lines into shorter splines to reduce the demand on your CPU and improve performance. Typically, splines cannot be trimmed between points. If you need to, you can do this with the Split Entities command, found in the Sketch Tools menu. And don't forget you can use the command search bar to find it and any other tools. Otherwise, when trimming a spline, it will chop between intersecting lines or endpoints only. So make sure you're clicking in the right place to begin with. When you're happy with your spline, double-click to end it. Points can be adjusted by spline handles after finishing a spline. And don't forget to add tangent or curvature relations between connected splines. Our initial reference sketch is looking good. So now we can remove the world map appearance and start separating our land from our water. To create the rest of the world, we'll use a three-step process. We'll use the Spline tool, found under the Curves dropdown, to score the sketch onto the face of the sphere. Ensure that intersection is selected from the Property Manager. Our splitting geometry is the reference sketch, and our face to split is that of the globe body. the face should split successfully into continents if there are no overlapping spline lines. To create the lines of longitude, we use the intersection curve tool. This tool creates a sketched curve at the intersection between planes, surfaces, faces, or parts. Hide out the globe body and show the reference sphere. Use the command search to find the intersection curve tool and select the right plane and the reference sphere to create a sketch at the point of intersection. We'll use this to sweep a cut into our globe. Hide the reference sphere and show the globe body again. Use the swept cut tool from the Features tab to sweep a circular profile cut around the sketched curve onto the globe body. We can now pattern this, but first we'll need an axis. Drop down the reference geometry and add an axis. Select the front and right planes to create a vertical axis at the center of our sphere. We'll then use a circular pattern to create 7 instances of equal spacing. Lines of latitude will be created using the Project Curve feature. Make sure to hide out the globe body again and show the reference sphere. Start a new sketch and draw the equator at the center. Draw 5 construction lines off from the center at 15 degrees from each other to the circumference. Then sketch horizontal lines from the endpoints across to the other side of the circumference. Exit the sketch, drop down the Curves tool, and select Project Curve. Choose the face of the reference sphere and select Bidirectional. This will wrap the sketch around the sphere. Hide the reference sphere and show the globe body for one final time. To make these blue curves usable, we need to start another new 3D sketch. Launch the Convert Entities tool and select the curves to convert them into sketches. Using the Swept Cut feature, we'll again cut circular profiles along these sketches. As they are paths made up of line segments, we need to use the Selection Manager to pick the full circumference. Right-click in the blue box and choose the Selection Manager. Select the path segments that make up one line, specify the diameter of the cut, and confirm the feature. Show the absorbed 3D sketch and repeat this for the other lines of latitude. Utilize the mirror feature and copy the lines from the northern hemisphere to the southern one over the top plane. And that's our globe modelled. All that's left to do is give it some appearances and get it rendered. Add your desired appearance, in this case white medium gloss plastic here, to the sweep features and all of the landmass faces. Then throw on a glass appearance to the part level to finish. The order is important here, as you should add transparent materials last for convenience. And finally, we'll pass our model through SolidWorks Visualize to see our world in all of its glory. Let us know down below in the comments what videos you'd like to see in the future. And don't forget to subscribe for more SolidWorks tips, tricks, and solutions.